I'm going to talk about a feature that Canvas recently made some changes to, some great upgrades called new analytics. This is the analytics feature in Canvas, which you may have seen before, but found not especially useful. So hopefully with these improvements, you'll be able to get some more utility out of it. So I'm going to go ahead and share my screen. Okay, so this is a test course that I have set up, and you can get to the new analytics feature on this global navigation panel that's available on any page that you're on in Canvas. If you're on the home page like I am right now, you can, oh, it's right down here. You can click new analytics, or you, if you're on the home page like I am right now, you can click on the new analytics button over here on the right hand side. And this will bring you to the new analytics page. It's loading my data right now. So like I said, this is my test course. So the data in this course isn't reflective of what it might look like in a typical course, but I have a couple workarounds for that. So I'm gonna go through the highlights of this tool here. So what you're seeing right here, the first thing it shows you is the average course grade. And there's also this chart that's gonna show us the average grade for every assignment in the course. If you had quizzes and graded discussions in the course, you could also filter by those. And you can switch this view to a table rather than a chart if you prefer that view. So this is again gonna show you the same information, each assignment and the average grade across all sections. I'm gonna switch back to the chart view. I'll show you here, I grabbed a screen grab from the Canvas documentation that shows kind of the filterability of this tool a little bit better. So what you're seeing here is you can compare all of the sections in the course to one particular section. So how one section did compared to everybody, that's shown here for the Monday, Wednesday, Friday group in green. And then you can also compare that either of these metrics with one individual student in the course. So they're comparing here on this chart, all of the sections with one section and then one individual student. And then you can also see right here where you can filter by assignments, discussions, and quizzes. So this is just to give you a better idea of the filtering that's available in the tool. So I'm going to click back into my course now, and I'll show you a little bit more about what that looks like. So if I select one student in the course, I can see now how her grades compare to the average grades in the course. And if I want to take a little bit of a deeper look at one individual assignment, I can click on that assignment, and it's going to open up this window that shows me very quickly the average grade on the assignment and the low and high scores, along with who is missing, who hasn't turned that assignment in, who's missing, and how many late submissions there were. If I click on either the missing or the late metric, it's going to show me the list of students in that group. And it will also show me the broad distribution of grades on that assignment. Another really nice feature here is that you can use this message student to envelope icon to send a message to all of the students who fall into a particular category that you determine. So I just clicked on that, and it's gonna open this new window. And then I can decide to send a message to students who maybe are struggling with this assignment or who haven't turned it in. I can set the range here. So you can see right now there are 4 students who submitted to this. If I change this to 80 to 100%, it's gonna automatically update that to just the 3 students who fall within that range. I can also click on the missing tab. This is gonna populate with the 5 students who are missing, or I can click on late and send it to students who have turned the assignment in late. That is pretty handy. I'll just close this window here. So the other parts of this tool that I want to highlight are the reports up here on the right, the furthest right tab. If I click that, it's going to bring up a list of reports that I can run and quickly see some information about everybody in the class. So I can see all of the assignments that are missing, the late assignments, students who've been excused from assignments, also the class roster and what Canvas deems course activity. So the other two tabs up here, the weekly online activity, this is still filtering for Shelly, so I'm only looking at her activity, but I don't have any recent activity in this course since it's my test course, but it would show you the page views and what Canvas calls the participation in the course. And then if you scroll down, you can see how many students have accessed each page in the course in the number of page views, which you may find useful. And then the students tab is just going to show me kind of a broad view of each student, how they're performing in the class, their grade, and some other metrics about them. So this feature, the new analytics tool, is enabled by default in all of the course sites running this semester and moving forward. We had like an older analytics version in the courses from last year. If you go back and look at a course that you taught in the fall of last year, you won't see this new analytics feature, but you can enable it for a past course. So if you go into your course, this is a course that is from, was set up last fall. And you go down here to settings. So this would only, you would only do this in an old course. And then go to the feature previews tab. You can scroll down here to the new course and user analytics, and you can enable that if this information is something that would help you maybe developing your course for this year. So that will do it for me and the new analytics. So I'll just go ahead and stop sharing the screen. And I hope that helps.